Hey my lovelies, welcome back to my channel. This is a pick a card reading, so it is so the person on your mind, someone that you may not have had contact with for a long time, or things didn't move in the way that you wanted them to move. So this is what they would like to say to you, or what they can't tell you. So we've got pile one, and don't ask me what the names of these two stones are, because I cannot remember. You know what, when I buy them I really should write down the names of them. So we've got this lovely stone here for pile one. Hope you can see that clearly. For pile two we have, I've got a necklace in this and I can't even remember the name, but anyway, it's a protection stone. And for pile two, and this one I do know, tiger's eye. So that's for pile three. So I'll let you choose your piles and I'll see you at your piles, okay? And don't forget, take what resonates, leave what doesn't. If it's not your pile, choose another pile, okay? So hey, pile one, so if you chose this stone, they're not a right idiot, but never mind. So this is your reading. I've picked a song, shuffled for a song, and then we'll go through your cards, okay? So your song from the person that's on your mind, what they want to say or what they can't say, is Missing You by Case. So it says, standing here looking out my window, my nights are long and my days are cold because I don't have you. How can I be so drawn? How can I be so damn demanding? I know you said that it's over now, but I can't let go. Every day I want to pick up the phone and tell you that you're everything I need and more. If only I could find you like a cold summer afternoon, like the snow coming down in June, like a wedding without a groom, I'm missing you. I'm the desert without the sand, you're the woman without a man. I'm a ring without a hand, I'm missing you. That's really sad. And I love this song. Oh, if you know, I'll put the names of the songs next to the piles, so if you want to go listen to it. But this, I really love the song. Reminds me, I think I was only 19 when this came out. That was many, many moons ago. I feel so old. But anyway, the good days. No responsibilities. But anyway, so right, they're your tarot cards. I'm going to put them down last. Okay. So what we got, and start with my cards first. So I cannot let you go, I'm too selfish. I am looking for that missing feeling. I have a lot of growing up to do. Okay. And then we've got denial. It's much easier to deny my feelings for you. Oh, I can already see that from these two cards here. But anyways. Then we've got fighting it. The harder I try to resist you, the weaker I seem to be. Let me just see if that's in shot, guys, because I think it is. I hope it is, anyway. Then we've got silent moves. I'm making moves in silence. Don't want anyone to ruin my plan. Breaking through. They are planning right now to come towards you to ask for a second chance. Expect communication real soon. Ooh. Hey, pile one, interesting. On a pedestal, you're the queen of their heart, the queen of their fiery guarded castle. It's only fear that makes them run. We can see that already. And then we've got ancestral karma. They're clearing negative ancestral patterns that pass down through generations. Don't rush the journey. And then we have unresolved, which we can see that. I love your scent, so I love your smell. Might be a certain perfume you wear or aftershave. You keep me up late at night. Lust in full gear. I love your body. Put that there. Then we have, you and your loved ones are safe. So it's the new moon in Cancer with that one. Then we have, your commitment is being tested. And your tarot cards are, just put that there. So we have the Two of Swords, Yeah, which literally clarifies the energy of this person here. The Three of Swords, love it. Transformation, a significant life experience that requires changes to be made, powerful and often unexpected revelations, breaking free of procrastination, releasing old belief systems. I'm liking this part one. Right, then we have, this is the Three of Wands. Planning for long-term abundance and past choices, pride in the success of labors, be patient as you decide what's next. Transformation, that is, I think that might be the Tower. Yep, yeah, it's the Tower, which, okay, right, hang on, let me just get my ass up and have a look and see if that you're in shock. Just bear with me, guys. Right, yep, yeah, you are. Brilliant. Okay, I'm liking this already. So my pile ones, what this person would like to tell you is that it could have been the things, maybe things didn't work out between you two, was because they're always looking for this missing feeling, you know. But what I feel like they've started to notice within themselves is that only they can fill up that missing feeling. You're not gonna be able to do that. Nobody else is gonna be able to do that. So it's like they're having some kind of awakening here. You know, like with this breaking through here, it's like the light bulb's on there. So it's like a light bulb moment that they're realizing that you may have been that missing feeling and they didn't realize, and they did a runner. So this person does have a lot of ancestral karma to get through. They may be already at the end of it here. And it could be because this person is in denial when it comes to you. It's like they're fighting it. They're in denial here. And they realise they've got a lot of growing up to do. But this is unresolved to them. And I feel like you keep me up late at night. Reminds me of the Nine of Swords energy here. So it's like they're constantly going over what they could have done better, what they could have done differently. So yeah. But you're definitely both, your commitment's being tested here is what this card says here. So this is like, you know, with the Tower as well. I think it's taking a lot of patience for you, Pile One, with this energy here. But there's a lot of communication coming through here, through certain cards here. So they are going to be reaching out. But I think it's going to surprise you because they're going to do it in a way that you're not going to be expecting it. You know, we've got the Tower as well here. So with the Tower here, I'm picking up that this person's had a realization of what they had with you, how they messed it up, how they've been going about in life. So it's like this big Tower moment. So like, you know, everything that they have beliefs in is literally just come crumbling down. They've been yearning for you for quite a while now. They've been waiting for the right time to come forward and speak to you. With the Two of Swords and the Three of Swords here, this causes heartbreak with you, with them. I feel like they felt they could go off and, you know, be okay about it. But it's like you're the one that they can't get over. You know, with the unresolved here as well. It's like, I feel like this energy didn't give the relationship a chance. They were always in the Two of Swords here of, should I be with this? Should I be with Pile One? Should I not be with Pile One? Am I doing the right thing? Am I not doing the right thing? You know, it's constantly always battling with themselves and their faults. And yeah. And, you know, see in here, they're releasing, and I believe this is like the Karma card here, they're releasing their old way of life. And they've tried to fight it here, Pile One, but it's not worked. I mean, like, you know, it could be that you two are divinely guided, that you know, you're supposed to be together, and this person didn't realise it. But there is a breakthrough here, that they've finally had this, oh, you know, okay. And I feel like that's their tower moment. Maybe there's worry here that it's too late. Maybe you've moved on pile one. So let's get some tarot cards. Let's get some more tarot cards here. Oh, I can't breathe. Asthma's a bit of crap today. So hang on. I want to clarify a few. I want to clarify this breaking through here. Tell me about this breaking through here, Spirit. Oh, hang on, sneaky. This was in these cards here, which it shouldn't have been in there. So maybe there's a message here for you. I'm ending a long-term relationship to be with you. So maybe this person was in a marriage or in a commitment already, and they couldn't be with you. It could have been because, you know, with the Three of Swords as well, okay, this can be a third party. So it could have been that maybe they thought, you know, I'm looking for that missing feeling here, and they went off with somebody else to start something with them, but they realised that missing feeling was you all along. So that could be why this was stuck in here, which it shouldn't have been. So for some of you, that may resonate, okay? So, Spirit, tell me about this breakthrough. The Star, yeah, and the Hierophant here as well. Oh, look, the Tower again. What a surprise! Tower. I don't think you've communicated with this person for a long time. Okay, we've got Death here as well. Death is an ending of a cycle, you know, transformations. So with these cards on the back here, this is the Tower, is obviously realizations, you know, leaving behind what you believed in. You know, it could even be another commitment here. You know, there's forward movement here. This is someone that is rushing towards you with the Chariot. Bear with me, guys. Yeah, this is someone that's about to take action towards you, because they haven't seen or spoken to you for a long time, you know, and they're ending this silence between you two as well. That's going to come to an end. There's going to be communication with both of you. Now, with the Star, we've got Aquarius energy here. This speaks of, you know, wish fulfillment, enlightenment, which literally clarifies the breakthrough card. They've literally been enlightened to the situation, enlightened to you, you know, how you, they feel about you. All along it was you, you know. Oh, I'm getting comfortable. Oh, that's better. So yeah, so we've got Aquarius, I think I said that, and the Hierophant. We've got Taurus energy here as well. So with the Hierophant, it can, like, two scenarios here. This could be someone that was married or in a serious commitment, but it also could be the overall energy is that they want to take your relationship, or hoping to take the relationship, to a more serious commitment here. This can be a high level soulmate here as well. So anyway, so what more does this energy want to say to my pile ones that they can't say or won't say? What more would they like to tell my pile ones? Okay, so what they want to tell you is they're ending karmic cycles here, which we've got that here. They could be ending the ending things with the karmic, which is the Empress. This could be someone's, it could be their wife, their husband, because don't forget, divine feminine, divine masculine. So this could be even the mother of their children. So they could have children with this Empress here. You know, with the Seven of Swords, it could be that they're trying to do it in a clever way, you know, to maybe not not draw attention to what they're doing. That could be why the silent moves is here as well, is because they don't want anybody to find out about you, because then, you know, you start getting people pointing fingers. So it's like the wheel is about to turn. It's, I feel like this whole relationship here that you both had is about to come full circle back around, and hopefully you both can do it properly, you know. But I also feel like they are ending it with a karmic here. Yeah, look, Prince of Cups, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. They've been spying on you as well. They've been checking your social media, making sure, you know, I suppose, if you're okay, what you've been up to. So yeah, they still keep an eye on you. You may not be aware of this, pile one. But this is also delayed news. This has been a long time coming, but it's delayed at the moment. But with the Page of Cups here, the Page of Cups speaks of something, someone that is sending a message. It's some kind of communication. Okay, it's from an admirer. So this is what they want to say to you, is that they are clearing out their karmic debt, clearing out the karmic, and they will be coming forward to communicate with you. That's whether you want to communicate with them, part one, you know. You could just be being nosy today. What's their next move, Spirit? What should part one expect from this person here? What should part one expect from this person? Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Yeah, look at this. Wow, look at this. So what to expect from this person? There's so much communication here. Eight of Cups, the Emperor. Wow. So what you need to expect from this person here is that there is a lot of communication here. It's something that's very swift, that's going to happen very quickly. Okay, yeah, something very quickly, big changes are coming towards you, swift news that you're not expecting here. Because the Prince of Wands, Princess of Wands, should I say, speaks about someone that is very passionate, someone that is, you know, is so passionate about this and still very passionate about you, and they're going to go after what they want. So yeah, expect communication here is what the energy is saying. Now we've got Libra energy as well. So yeah, this person's made their mind up. They've made the decision. They're taking back, you know, their power. They're taking responsibility for maybe their actions. But they are saying that they've made a decision and they are going to be reaching out to you. They want to tell you that they, you know, they may have invested a lot of time and energy into somebody else, but they are leaving it behind to be with you. So what advice would you give to my pile ones in regards to this? How should they handle it? What advice would you give? Any warnings? You're going to be very conflicted when it comes. You've got the Two of Swords here again. You're going to be very undecided. You're going to be confused about this whole situation, about this person here. You know, it could be that you may need to compromise. You look, spying again. You feel betrayed by this person. I feel like you still hold on to what they did to you. This is why you're going to be in the Two of Swords energy here, that, you know, you can't seem to decide what you want to do. Because of, obviously, they went off with somebody else. I'm picking that up quite strongly here, pile one. You know, they left you out in the cold. They abandoned you. Yeah, they abandoned you. And with the moon here, this is all about illusions and secrets, things that were kept hidden from you. It could have been that you just wasn't even aware of this person being involved with someone else or leaving you for somebody else. Cancer, no, Pisces energy here. Tell me about this moon. What do my part ones need to be aware of, spirit? Tell me about the moon. Tell me about the moon. Wow, that keeps coming out. That's three times now. Oh, okay. What's being hidden from you, which you're not aware of? It could be that you've not even thought about this person. Maybe they do cross your mind from time to time because you've had no contact with them, okay? And it could be that, you know, you just... I feel like you're going to be surprised when this person reaches out, because the Princess of Swords is the spying card, it is delayed news. And what's being hidden from you is that this person still checks up on you, still keeps an eye on you, you know? Tell me about the Princess of Swords. I feel like with you, Pile One, that your problem is trust. Can you trust this person not to do that again? From what I can see in the card is yes, you can, because they've grown up, basically. You know, with that up there, I'm looking for the missing feeling. I have a lot of grown up to do. And then you go through the cards. It's like a little story saying, yes, that's what I needed to do. I was a selfish ass. I'm in denial, I was fighting it, but then I've had this enlightenment down here, you know, that I've woken up to what I really had, who, you know, who you was to them. So tell me about this Princess of Swords, spirit. Oh, wow. Wow, Two of Swords again, guys. The Hermit, yeah, somebody you've not seen for a while. See, this is someone that's been in the dark, someone that's been hiding behind the scenes, okay? Not stalkerish vibes, but this is someone that keeps themselves to themselves. You're just not aware that they're checking up on you. And I feel like they've buried their feelings so like deep here with the moon, is that they don't let on to anybody how they feel about you. Now we have the Devil here. The Devil speaks of toxic relationships and commitments. It can be codependency, it can be you know, drugs, alcohol, but it also could be this obsession with you, because they can't have you, they can't be with you, they obsess by checking your social media, like looking at your photographs, you know. And I feel like they do it every day, but they do it in the dark. You see, I feel like they do it maybe at night time when maybe this whoever they're involved with is not around, and they sit there for hours looking at your photographs, you know. So make sure you post some good ones online, guys. I'm such a bitch. You know, put a few bikini shots on there, or if you're a man, you know, get your chest out, you know, you never know. Look what you're missing. I'm such a cow. Anyway, tell me about the Devil. Two of Cups. Yeah, you guys are soulmates here. Eight of Pentacles. Ten of Pentacles. Wow. So, you two are soulmates here. This is a loving connection. You know, it could have been what you had before, but they were too blind to see it. They see it now. They do see it. You know, and this is, you know, someone that could be coming, you know, they could be bringing a proposal to you, you know, maybe take it slow. But yeah, they, and the Devil actually go, like, clarifies the pedestal here. They still put you in, they still see you in high regard, you know, like someone that just cannot compare to you. So this is someone that is deeply in love, that would like to take the connection to the next level, you know, maybe rekindle the old love. This is like reunions, reconciliations as well. They would really like to work on this with you. They're hoping that you will want to work on the connection as well and build back up this Two of Cups that you both may have had. And this is, I love this card, and I'm glad this card came out, because I'm not worried about the devil energy. I just think this person's just obsessed with you. So yeah, Ten of Pentacles is guaranteed. This is, you know, family, community, commitment, building a life together. It's pure abundance, you know. You two, this is the life that you could have, which is guaranteed. Marriage, stability. You know, this is something you can pass down to your children, and then their children. You know, it's leaving a legacy behind. So my pile ones, I'm actually going to leave it there. Actually, no, let's get some gems. I'm feeling like some gems here. Let's get some letters and gems. And then, I'll go for my drink. I broke my little fairy. Really upset about that. Okay, let's get some gems, letters as well. So, let's have a look what we got here. So, the letters we have, so this could be in their initials, this can be the letters in their name. It could even be in yours as well, or it could be, you know, something that means something to you, you know, like a place. I don't know. So anyway, turn my ring around. So we've got K, then we've got Y, X, I, E, M, we've got Q, got Z, Z, M again, we've got K again, a J, we've got quite a lot of letters here, and a E. So that could be in their name, these letters, or yours, or their initials are here. So, you know, this could be your reading. So anyway, that's the letters. And then we have, bring it closer to me, lean across bloody table. Yeah, look, we've got push chair here. So, you know, from what I said before, I feel like this person has children with the Empress that came out. It could be even you've got children, or it could be that, you know, you take what resonates. It could be that you all have children together, because with the Ten of Pentacles here, that's all about children as well, starting a family. So yeah, but children is very it's in your both your, you know, energy here. So yeah, children are important here. We have a hat, a baseball cap. So it could be this person likes to wear baseball caps. It could be they could even have a collection of baseball caps. Could even be you guys. Could even be they play baseball, you know. And we've got a turtle here, which is turtles are slow moving energy. So this could have been, like I said, a very long time coming. It's taken ages to, you know, happen. We've got two fishes here. So this could be Pisces, but this is very abundant for both of you. You know, fishes are good luck and success, which you've got that with the Ten of Pentacles there. And then we've got the star. We've actually got the moon and the star here. So Aquarius energy and Pisces energy is what I'm picking up. Strong energy here with the both of these as well, which is in the cards as well. So yeah, with the star, it could have been, I'm picking this up as star energy, which you've got the star card. You know, this is wish fulfillment. This has been something that this energy's wanted for a long time. You know, they've been manifesting you back, and I feel like maybe you've been manifesting them as well. Then you have the hand, which is a religious symbol like the Turkish eye. I don't know if you can actually see my Turkish eye, but yeah, this is protection. So I do feel like that you are both divinely protected here. You know, I do feel like it's a very strong soulmate connection with both of you. And then with the dragonfly here, this is good luck. This is spreading your wings, both of you, you know, taking flight in the connection. yeah, so anyway, pile one, good reading. So if you like this video, please hit like. If you're new here, please consider to subscribe and hit that notification bell, please. Anyway, I'll see you soon. Bye. Hey, pile two. So if you chose this stone, I can't remember what it's called, but I hope. So right, these are your cards, and I've got you a song from this energy, from this person to you. So we have Soulmate by Flora Cash, and I will be putting the names of the songs next to each pile, okay? So we've got song do that again. Soulmate, 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 won't you dance here with me while it grows late? Put your head on my chest, that's your safe place. We'll fall deeper in love every day. From life and to life and for always, I'll be there when you need me around. When night finally comes and the leaves have fallen from the tree, baby, you'll have me, soulmate. So we're getting strong soulmate connection here, guys. So let's have a look. Interesting. I love that song. Very old, but I do like it. I love old songs, but maybe because I'm old. So I fear what people will say. STI. Accept it, I have moved on. Okay. Wow. Escapism. Drinking seems to be the only thing that numbs my mental agony. Wow. Pile two. Did I say pile one earlier? If I did, I do apologize. Apology. I'm sorry for disappointing you. Will you accept my apology? Lessons. I'm learning a divine lesson and will soon be by your side. Breaking free. They are freeing themselves from their self-imposed prison and leaving behind all that has kept them away from you. Wow, this reading's pretty deep. Past life. Their soul recognized your soul from the moment they met you. They knew you were the one they've been waiting for. You guys got extra cards. Children are affecting this connection. Be patient, allow them to restore things to the highest good of all. Then we have, I'm planning a surprise. I'm hurting, which we can see that from the cards. This person sounds like a mess. I'm afraid to contact you. The passion is strong. Oh, hang on, there are your tarot cards. Put them there. And then we have, be bold and make the first move. Nothing will come of this situation. Wow, that might be spirit telling you to maybe see a few warnings here. So we've got tarot cards, death. Yep. Hanged man. Mm-hmm. And we have the Six of Swords. The ending of challenging times. Things are looking up. A welcome relief. Finding your way to a peaceful place. The end of depression or an illness. Travel or relocation. Which is nice because this person is suffering mentally here. And then children. Children or childhood. Revisiting old dreams or plans. Embracing your inner child. The return of people or romances from your past. Romanticizing about things that used to be. Yeah, look. Oh, wow. Reading, you know, and I don't look at the cards when I shuffle them, they come out and I put them in your piles. Oof. So I'm getting a strong vibe of two scenarios here, okay? It could be that my pile twos, this person cheated on you and they gave you an STI, or it could be that because they've gone off and got out of control, they've caught, you know, a sexual transmitted disease. And I think their attitude towards you was, you know, I feel like pile two, you got very hurt. Maybe you tried to talk to this person, convince this person, you know, please don't leave. And they've had that attitude of accept it, I've moved on. But then it could actually be that they're telling whoever they're involved with, accept it, I'm, you know, moving on. And this, I feel what people will say, maybe you guys had a bit of a toxic connection here. Maybe this person brought a lot of drama into your life and, you know, they're worried about what friends and family would say if they were to reach out to you. But it looks like they've got some addictions going on here. And they do really, their energy is saying, whether they will or not, I don't know yet, their energy is saying they really would like to apologize, but you know, it's whether you would accept their apology here. And the divine lessons over here as well is their higher self is telling you that they're learning their lessons in life. You know, they're trying to clear themselves up. They've been going through a lot of depression here, and they will be by your side soon. You know, look, they're breaking free of all this drama, all this toxicity in their lives as well. And I do feel like because your soulmate's here, and we've got the past life, you had the soulmate card, you've got this past life connection here. And it could be even like, you know, because it's a soulmate, sometimes, you know, sometimes one of the soulmates or the twin flames, they don't learn their lessons, that they're not working at a higher vibration. You know, you could be working at one level and they're in this other, you know, low devil energy, if you know what I mean. And that's what I feel like this connection was. So it could be you've got children and they've got children, you know, they moved on with somebody else here, but they're planning something here. But they're really scared to contact you. And they do recognize that the passion between you two was very strong when you were together. But spirit is saying nothing will come of this situation. So it could just be for this energy here, pile two, it could be they just want to reach out to maybe to lay things to rest, basically, because it could be that this is what's been playing on their mind for a long time and they treated you like crap. So basically they want to come forward and talk to you and apologize. And I do feel like it would be a sincere apology here. You've got the Six of Cups here, which is reconciliation. So I do believe there is a reconciliation here, or they want to reconcile with you. But it is, if you were to both come together, it would be you both reminiscing about the past, you know. This is someone that you could have gone to school with. And, you know, it was a young love at the time. But they are moving into the Six of Swords here, which is lovely that they're sorting themselves out and they're on their way to calmer times ahead, peaceful times ahead. Illnesses, they're healing from any illness that they had, which seems to be their mental health and addictions over there. You know, death is a transition, you know, things ending. So I do believe this person is ending their way of life. And they're transitioning into a better person here. You know, the Hangman is that they've wasted enough time and energy with this way of life. They've had some kind of, you know, enlightenment here from, I think it was like from their angels and ancestors and their spirit guides, you know, that you can't keep going down this road. But I do feel like they're being divinely guided back to you to maybe give you this apology that you deserve, pile two, okay? Was a mouthful. Not those ones. Hang on. Let me grab these ones. Right, okay. Oh god. Tell us more about this energy here. What would they like to tell my pile twos but can't or won't? What would they like to tell my pile twos? So we've got the Four of Swords and the Wheel. So the Four of Swords speaks to someone that is emotionally drained, someone that is all up in their head. And it also could be what this person telling you is that I know that I haven't seen you for so long. And I do believe this has been a very long time, especially with the Six of Cups here. So they know they haven't seen you for a very long time, but they've had to deal with their karma here. You know, karmic situations, karmics, and they've had to pay these karmic debts off. And you know, the nice thing is with the Chariot here, it's forward movement, it's making a change. So I do believe that they're really like transforming themselves. You know, the Death literally says it as well. So yeah, this is like, but it also could be coming back at full circle here with the Wheel. So, you know, like what goes around comes around. you know, or comes back around, if you know what I mean. So it's like it's going to come back around to you again, pile two, if you know what I mean. I'm trying to explain it as best I could. Best I can, sorry. So what else would this energy like to say to my pile twos? It could have been when you were together, they started going down, you know, another scenario here that I'm seeing is when you were together, they started going down this road here of addictions, okay, and getting spiraling out of control. And then you may have even been the one that you left them, you know, accept it, I've moved on. So that could even be your energy coming through, guys, and you're worried about what people are going to say about the situation if you were to let this person come back in your life. And I'm speaking 10 to the freaking dozen here, but anyway, it's all, you know, when I hear it, I've got to say it. So that could have been why you left this person as well, because you couldn't be around this situation. It could be that you may have had children with this person. For some of you, you know, maybe not, but you had to put yourself first, okay? We have the Page of Swords. Air sign, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. We have the Page of Wands as well. Wow. Okay. So the Page of Swords here, it speaks of delayed news. So this is still something in the process that's happening behind the scenes that you're not aware of. This person still watches your social media. They still check up on you. They like to see what you're doing. They like to look at your pictures here. And with the Page of Wands is another communication card here. And they're very, you know, they're coming up with a way to maybe approach you, but it's actually something that is going to come out of nowhere. So, you know, expect some kind of communication here. I do feel like there is going to be a reconciliation with the pair of you here. I'm not picking up romantic though. I just feel like just maybe to clear the air. Okay, because we've got the Six of Swords as well, which is, you know, laying things to rest, smoothing things over, doing, you know, doing what's right. And that's what I feel like they are wanting to do. So what should my pile twos expect from this person here, Spirit? What are their next move towards my pile twos, or what should they expect? Wands. Yeah, look, they're gonna work really hard, I feel like, for you to forgive them and show, they want to show you that they've been working really hard on themselves and they've transformed and changed their life around. Okay, this is what they want to show you, that they're a better person here. Okay, because we've got the Six of Wands. Six of Wands is victory, it's success. So they want to show you that they were successful in turning their life around. And they've had, I feel like they've had a lot of victories in their life, you know, recently. They're doing, you know, good for themselves. Life is positive is what I'm picking up with this energy. You know, I feel like they're very proud of themselves here, that you know, they could even be in AA. I'm not a doctor, but this is what I'm picking up here. And they really want to share this news with you. Okay, I feel like they really hate the fact that you may have looked down on them, not that you did, but this is what haunts them to this day. You know, and this is justice. This is something that needed to be done. This is something that they have to do. They have to come forward and, you know, because this is karma as well. They have to come forward and make things right with you. They know this. I feel like out of everybody in their life, you're the one that they hurt the most. You had this special bond, soulmate connection here. So, what advice would you give my pile twos in regards to this situation here, Spirit? What advice would you give them? You know, this is what they want to say. This is, you know, if they weren't going to come forward, there wouldn't be any communication here. But the news is delayed, guys. But you will be hearing from this person. They will be wanting to talk to you and apologize. So yeah, what should you, what advice would you give my pile twos? Spirit saying the advice to you is expect communication. They're an emperor now, guys. This is beautiful. They're an emperor. Yeah, look, I love it. They've really turned themselves around here, guys. Honestly, you should, you know, if you know, maybe they've hurt you too much and you're like, I really don't want to hear from this person, but I feel like Spirit is saying here, please hear this person out. They're not the energy that they used to be. They are now an emperor, divine masculine here. So yeah, this is someone that is, has taken charge of their life, is in control of their life now, okay? So Spirit is saying what to expect, you know, is communication. And obviously the Emperor, and we've got the Fool here. They're on a new beginning here. They're taking a leap of faith here. They're trusting that you're going to let them start again. So like I said, I don't see anything romantic here, but you know, you never know what can come down the road. This is just the energy I'm picking up now. They're actually just all about themselves at the moment, not meaning selfish energy. It's just they want to apologize. They're very passionate about their new start in life. They've put everything behind them here. You know, they're balanced out now. They've got peace and harmony here. They're in alignment with themselves. They've left all their burdens behind here, okay? That Knight of Pentacles is communication as well. It's been a long time coming here, this communication, and they know they've taken a long time to come forward and communicate with you. So let's get some letters and charms here. So this person could have the letters in their name, or it could be their initials. It could even be your initials and letters in your name as well, guys, okay? Got the letters M, the letters S, the letters R, the letter B, F, X, Z. We've got the letter K, the letter J, and the letter Q. So this could be your initials, their initials, or letters in your names here. So you know, then it, you know, it's your reading, or it could even be an important place or something that is in the with the place could have. Jesus, what is wrong with me today? The letters could be in the name of a place that you have memories with this person. You know, like something that from your childhood or whatever. You got it out in the end, guys. Got it out. So we've got a heart here. So yeah, this person still feels a strong connection to you. There's still love here with you both. Then you have musical notes. So it could be, you know, they speak to you through music, or they listen to music and it reminds them of you, certain songs. You may have had a song that you both had together. Camels, this is someone that's here for the long haul here. This is someone that will take on the burdens of others, or take the responsibility of what they've done. You know, they've matured into the camel here, okay? And this is what we're getting in the reading, that they are taking responsibility for everything that they did, and this is what they're carrying around with them, and I feel like they need to release it. We have the Star, so you could be wish fulfillment to this person. This could be Aquarius energy here. So it could be that you oh yeah, by the way, we've got Sagittarius energy as well here, and Aries energy. So yeah, your wish fulfillment, it could be they're manifesting you back in to their life, or they have been, or it could be you've even been manifesting this person back. Then we have don't know what that is, leave that there. Yeah, look, the tree. No, that's the peacock. Ooh, peacock. look at the peacock in two certain ways here. This is like someone that is very handsome, very good looking here, and they know it, and they've got this little strut, they've got this strut about themselves when they walk in a room, you know, because they know they're good looking. Cocky is the word, cocky. But it also could be that they find you very beautiful, you know, when the peacock opens their feathers, how attractive they are, how beautiful they are. So that's another way I'm looking at that as well. They see you as the queen. They see you, they put you on a pedestal. You are their queen and always will be. Paris as well, we've got the Eiffel Tower here. So it could be maybe you two went away to Paris together, had a little holiday in Paris. It could have even been, you may have celebrated, while I'm here, in celebration of like an anniversary or something in Paris. Or it could have been that you two both spoke about Paris, but you never got around to doing it. So Paris, France, Paris is quite, I'm picking out, it's quite strong in this reading. And then we have the dragonfly here. The dragonfly is someone that wants forgiveness, wants to move towards you to receive this forgiveness as well. And I feel like, you know, that this can grow into something more beautiful, how it used to be before everything went wrong. So guys, I'm going to leave it there, my poll twos. I hope this resonated for you, and if it did, please hit like. If you're new, please hit subscribe. I'd love to have you, and you take care. Bye. Hey, pile three. So if you chose, oh, my breath, I had to run to the loo. Tiger's Eye, this is your reading. So I've got a song for you from the person that you've been thinking about, or this person that wants to communicate with you, tell you how they're feeling, what they want to say. So Lost Without You by Freya Ridings. Love this song. So it says, standing on the platform watching you go, it's like no other pain I've ever known. To love someone so much, to have no control. You said, I want to see the world, and I said, go. But I think I'm lost without you. I just feel crushed without you. I've been strong for so long that I never thought how much I needed you. I think I'm lost without you. I love that song. So this person's very lost without you, from what they're saying. So I'm feeling a lot of love from this person, but it's like they had to let you go. And I feel like, why, you know, they watched you walk away. So tarot cards there. Start with these cards. I don't feel good enough for you. The grass was not greener. They always think it is, isn't it? Please forgive me for all the hurtful words I said to you. Okay. You guys, don't tell the other piles, okay guys, you guys, your cards, like literally you got a lot of extra cards. It's like I'm trying to, when I shuffled and I had your pile ready, I had two cards balancing on my hand, so I was trying to put it back over here and it was like it wasn't having it, and then it flicked and I thought, right, okay, spirit wants me to take those cards for you. So yeah, you got extra cards. So we've got erased. I deleted everything that reminds me of you. Telepathic. I close my eyes, speak to you in 100 silent ways. Oh, this is sad. I feel really sad with your reading. I'm picking up really sad energy here, guys. Decision. I've made up my mind. I'm not wasting time anymore. Worth waiting for. Wow. If anything, yours is really positive. Forever changed. You changed my life without even trying. The old me is dead and gone. Yeah, look at the mask he's wearing in this. And we have wishing well. There's a lot of excitement in the air. You've awakened a new life in them that has them lost in a field of possibilities. Ooh, part three. Frequency. They are aligning to the frequency of love and operating at a high frequency vibration with openness to receiving. Okay, that's what I'm getting from this card here. I feel like their spirit guides of, and even the universe is being waked, showing them things, showing them the way, enlightening them to certain things. Anyways, stone. They are emotionally unavailable. It is for the highest good to move on and find your happiness again. So I don't see that's actually anything to do with you, but I'll come back to that. Then we've got missing you, which we've just heard with what's the name of the bloody song? Lost Without You. Their life feels empty without you. They miss you more than words can say, but they think it's too late to fix things. It could have been a very long time picking up as well. Let's get these first. Yeah, look, we've got loads of these as well, where the others didn't. My life is a mess. Okay. I speak to you through music. There you go. You've got a song back there. This love is making me lose my mind. I wish you were closer. I have trouble with intimacy. So many things remind me of you. A new start is coming. So a new moon, maybe on the next new moon. The answers you need are coming. Wow. Gemini there, guys, as well. Okay, let's get your tarot cards. I don't know whether you're going to be able to see all, actually. Let me just put that there for a minute. So I've got room down here, okay? And then with tarot cards are Six of Wands, Nine of Cups, wow. What is this? Number one. Zero is the Fool. Number one is the Magician. A windfall of abundance, wise consort, a good fortune, an exciting career opportunity, a lucrative contract, significant purchases like a home or vehicle. Oh no, this is the Ace of Coins. She's carrying a book with a coin on it. Okay, cool. And oh God, he looks so fed up, guys. This is the King of Swords. Intelligent, impartial, respected, stoic, receiving wise advice, remain objective, a fair-minded, public speaking, communicative, communicate clearly, and emotional relationships or being emotionally unavailable. Now, where did we just see that, guys? Where was it? Where is it? Where did I just see that? I have trouble with intimacy. This is the problem with the King of Swords here. Anyways, I'm put those two there. Wow, pile three. This is a bit deep. Oh, where to start with you guys? So for my pile threes, what I'm picking up here is this person that you think about every now and again, or is still on your mind, what they would like to tell you but can't or won't, is that they want to tell you that the grass was not greener. So I feel like this person left you for somebody else. They chose somebody else over you is a strong vibe I'm getting here, okay? They feel like that you are somebody that is either too good for them, too attractive, too successful. You know, maybe they could look at your social media and think, oh my God, their life is amazing. How can I come back when I don't really have much, you know, to offer them? So they feel like they're beneath you is what I'm picking up. So I feel like the last time you spoke to each other, they said some very harsh words to you that I feel like you've always carried around with you, you know, that deep hurt here. But that you both communicate to You both have this telepathic communication going on with both of you. It could be through dreams, it could be through music, you know. But there are things that they got rid of. They don't hold on to anything from the past here that remind them of you because it hurts too much. So yeah, I feel like where they've been awakened, look, speak to you from music, where they've been awakened by this, by spirit here, it's now really hit them that this love that they had with you was a one of a kind, you know. And there is huge regret here because we've got the frequency here. They are coming into alignment. There are messages being delivered to them, they're making a decision here whether to reach out to you. But they want you to know, maybe when you were younger, when I don't know why I'm stuttering, I had no problem with any of the other piles. But what they want to say to you is, when you were together, or maybe you didn't even move into a connection, you know, maybe it was like a bit of hope. I'm picking up like young love here. They wore a mask. They didn't show you who they were. It could have been they were hiding things from you as well and not telling you the truth. This stone here is goes with the King of Swords here, being emotionally unavailable. I don't think they're unavailable. I feel like they don't know how to express their emotions. They don't know how to show their emotions. We've got Gemini, Libra, Aquarius here. So yeah, they just don't know how to... strong Gemini here. How to express themselves. Now with the Six of Wands, this is news. This is good news. This is victory. This is success, you know. And the Nine of Cups is all about wish fulfillment and success and happiness as well. So I feel like if this person actually had the balls to reach out to you, this could actually make them very happy. You've got the Ace of Pentacles here. The Ace of Pentacles is an abundant new beginning. It's starting again. It's building a life together. It could be a new job, you know, money, success, but relationships as well and commitments here. But the good thing about the King of Swords as well, King of Swords can actually, they don't get emotional about things. I feel like they're trying to be practical in this situation here, even though they see you as wish fulfillment and they've got all this missing you and they're being told by their spirit guides to, you know, move forward, reach out to you. It's like they're trying to be practical about it. But the answers, Spirit is saying the answers that you've always wanted from this person, it could be maybe you never got the answer of why they did what they did. But Spirit is saying it's on its way to you. And a new start, a new beginning is coming here. You know, you've got worth waiting for as well. So I feel like where it's been so long, it could be that, you know, after all this time, it was worth waiting. Whether you've gone off and had separate lives, you know, you've got involved with someone, they've got involved with someone, had children, you know. I do feel like this is a very old relationship or love here. So anyway, tell me about this. Please forgive me for all the hurtful words I said to you. Yeah, look, they had to make a three of wands energy here. They had to make a decision, okay? They had to choose a path for themselves. It could have been, I'm picking up strongly here, that it could have been that they got, I don't know why I'm picking up arranged marriage here, like a family dynamic here, that they had to make a decision about you. Maybe they felt like, you know, you weren't the right fit for them. And they made this decision and they chose another person and they moved forward with that person. But hurtful things were said. It could have even been that they never even told you about this person. That's why they were wearing a mask here. But what had happened was throughout the years, if it's been, I do feel it, really, really do feel like it's been years here for you. You know, you don't have to take that as part of your reading. It could have been only like a few months, but take what resonates. This person, when they made that decision, all they've done is yearn for you. So they turned their back on you here. They walked away from you. But I feel like you needed to walk away as well. That could be why that song there is when they watched you go. You had no choice but to leave this person behind because they'd already made a decision to move on with somebody else. So over the years, they've yearned for you. I feel like there's a lot of what would have happened, you know, could have, would have, should have, and all that kind of thing. And I feel like this person got involved. Yeah, look at the spirit. Oh dear. This is, yeah, this is, I feel like this is karma. They got involved with someone that was not for their better good here. Someone that could have been codependent on them, or was codependent, or is codependent, okay? This relationship was toxic. It could have even been just about sex, you know, when they got together. I'm sorry if you don't want to hear that, but that's what I'm seeing here with the Devil card. So we've got Capricorn energy as here as well. We've got Taurus energy as well. So yeah, they chose somebody else. It could have been, like I said, with this arranged marriage or arranged relationship, I don't know, but this was something that they had to do. So this was a marriage here, a serious commitment made to somebody else, but it turned out to be very toxic for them. It didn't go very well. This person that they got involved with was not letting them go. It was like they were holding on to them so tightly. Yeah, this is something, this person, this energy is being married or in a commitment with this person for a very long time. I'm looking at years here for some of you, okay? You know, Three of Swords is third party situation. It's heartbreak, it's ending of a relationship. So yeah, I feel like this is what they did to you. You know, they entered into a connection that was, that they chose wrong, basically. Arsehole. Anyways, right, tell me about this decision for my pile threes. I have to keep checking my recording. I did this yesterday, took me over 2 hours. Oh my god, the thing cut out just towards the end of the reading. I was so upset. I was like, oh my god, I think I've got to buy a new camera. So I'm just double checking. I hope it don't do it, because I'll be very upset. Tell me about this decision, please, Spirit. Oh, chicken egg. We have the Six of Swords. Yeah, look, they want to... Hang on, tell me more about the Six of Swords. Tell me more about the decision. So Six of Swords speaks of moving from rough waters to calmer waters. You know, making peace with the past or situation. Tell me more about this decision here, please, Spirit. And I've got a funny feeling. I don't know why it cut out. It's done it only twice to me, but it may have been that Spirit didn't want that to get out. Death, yeah, they're ending. Thanks, Spirit, love it. Thank you. Look, weighing up their options, making a decision, okay? They're doing what's right for them, all right? Then we've got the Six of Swords, like I said, moving from calm waters to smoother waters here, because they're making up their mind. They're not wasting any more time. Okay, I feel like they've wasted years on someone that didn't deserve them. But I feel like this was part of their karmic cycle here that they had to pay off. So yeah, they've made a decision to end things with whoever it is that they're involved with here. So this is a transformation. This is an ending. They're leaving it behind, right? That was what they were weighing up. That was, you know, what decision they've come to. Yeah, so this literally clarifies everything. The answers that you've been wanting, a new start here. So what more does this person want to tell my pile threes here, Spirit? What do they want to tell pile three? Scorpio energy here as well. What do they want to tell my pile three? Oh, that was stubborn. Fire sign, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius here. Look at this, guys. Yeah, look. They want to tell you that they are very passionate about this. They're on a mission, okay? There's still a lot of passion they have for you. And they are coming towards you to pursue you, you know. They're charging back. Yeah, Knight of Wands. I like to see this. Yeah, very, very passionate about this. They want a new beginning with you with the Fool. They want to take this chance, you know. Okay, you may not want them back, but they're willing to take this leap of faith to be with you. Whereas the Eight of Swords, they were up in their head, thinking constantly, worrying. Is there, you know, just constantly being their own worst nightmare when it's the other way around. But where it's reversed, they've now got clear thinking now. They know that there was a way out of the situation that they were involved with, and they know there is a way back to you, okay? So, okay, what more do we need to know? I need to cover that up. I'm gonna cover the King of Cups' privates up. Don't want to get in trouble. Look what we got again on the back of the deck. The Eight of Swords again, reversed. So, look, they invested a long time with somebody else, with the Ten of Cups here. But they see you as their happily ever after now, not the person that they were involved with. They're having to leave this connection behind. You know, I do feel like they've got children with this person. They built a life together, you know, something that they invested a long, long time with someone, okay? So what's happened here is they know that they have to leave it behind because it's not serving them no more. All it did was bring them a lot of grief and sorrow. You know, I don't feel like they had that, you know, I feel like they had a few good memories. But there was a lot of heartache that come with this connection here. And I feel like this is why... This is why this energy is in the Swords energy here, and I lack intimacy, blah, 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 because they never had it with this person. It could be where with the Devil energy that came out earlier, that this person was very cold towards them, you know? And I feel like they were very lonely while they were in this connection. That's why, they, you know, this is loneliness and suffering and grieving. And I do feel like this connection brought them a lot of suffering, okay? And now with the King of Cups here, I've got Heidi's bits there because it's very inappropriate. I remember when I first used these, I didn't even notice. And it was like, oh, for a reading. But anyway, so with the King of Cups, it's Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. He's someone that is very passionate. He's got this cup of love. Look, he's holding the cup out, you know, and he does have this love but I feel like it's been trapped for so long, you know, because I feel like this was a marriage of convenience. I'm picking up here for some of you, all right? It may not have been, but there was a lot of coldness between both of them. And he has this big cup of love to give to you. You know, this is someone that is kind, someone that is sincere, very passionate. So this is what he's wanting to say, or she's wanting to say, that their partnership with this person, you know, they felt trapped with this person, but they're not trapped anymore. I feel like they're out of this now, or coming out of it. So let's have a look. Tell me about this, a new start is coming, spirit. Why is that in there now? Oh my God. You've got an extra card that snuck into the tarot cards here. Well, really, that happened in one of the other piles. No, that was there. I've picked it up. Okay. Okay, maybe the energy is literally screaming, I miss you, because it ended up in there again. We know you miss them. So anyway, tell me about this new start is coming. That was weird. Tell me about the new start for my pile phrase. Tell me about the new start that is coming. Those candles smell so nice. Those little diddly little ones that I've got burning over there. So lovely. What about the new start? Maybe they don't want to say. Three of Pentacles in reverse. Love it. Right, in the past they were conflicted about... that's another card that I need to be careful of. They were very conflicted about their situation and what to do, okay? So they've been very confused. But if they take off the blindfold, which I do believe the blindfold has come off now, and they've got this realization that it's always been you. Now, with the Three of Pentacles upright, it can be a third party situation, it can be a collaboration, but I feel like because it's reversed, this was a third party situation. So there, a new start is coming. I believe this person's coming towards you. They're clearing out the third party here to move towards you because they are very passionate about you here. And when the King of Wands wants something, he goes for it when he's passionate about it. So what more do we need to know about this and this person here? What more? What's their next move towards my part three spirit? What's the next move? Oh, maybe flick over. What's their next move? Cards want to come out, but they're not coming out. What's the next move towards my pile three? Maybe we're not meant to know. Wow, I don't think they want you to know, my pile three. Let's have a look. Page of Pentacles. They've got a plan. They have a plan. This is why I don't think, I feel like it's struggling to tell me what it is. Maybe they don't want anyone to know. What is their next move? Whoa. Towards part three, nine of... So this is success, this is. This is someone that's single. So I feel like they may have been single for a little while, you know, may have cleared out all this, may have been single trying to get their life in order at the moment. But something's always been missing in their life, which is their 10th pentacle, which is you. Let's have a look. Tell me more, Spirit. What does this person want to tell my pile three? It's being very stubborn in letting us know what it is that they're planning here. I do really believe this person doesn't want you to know. I'm picking up High Priestess vibes here. Or the Moon. Oh my God, come on, Spirit. What is their next move? I don't think we're supposed to know, pile three. Got the King of... All we need to know is that they're passionate about you. Very passionate about you. The Eight of Wands. There's communication coming towards you. Swift movement, okay? This energy is moving towards you quite quickly. Because we have the Knight of Wands as well. That's fast moving energy as well. So yeah, expect some kind of communication. Communication card again. You've got the Nine of Cups twice here, which is you are wish fulfillment to this person. So, right, let's get some advice for you. What advice would you give my pile three? Because this energy has been very stubborn. It's like they don't want you to know. I do feel like because it is going to be a surprise for you. So, tell me about what advice would you give my pile threes? What does my pile threes need to know? Jesus, today, not tomorrow. What does my pile threes need to know, Spirit? Spirit wants you to know that this has been a long time coming, okay? This is someone that takes their time, you know, King of Swords, takes their time to do things properly, and that's what this energy's done. They've done things properly, they've cleared out the past, and they're coming towards you with communication. So, you know, this has been, you know, the Knight of Pentacles is the slowest moving energy in the deck. So this has been years, okay, for you guys. There's victory and success and news on its way to you. they've ended, and a connection has ended here, a relationship is over. Look, third party, but this could be someone that's coming towards you to communicate with you and talk about, you know, maybe getting together to, you know, for a meal or something to eat. This is someone's father, so they could have children. Divine masculine, this is Taurus energy here. So this is the divine masculine. This is someone that takes charge, knows what they want. Yeah, look, they're their own master of their own future here. They're the magician. This is someone that, you know, has the tools to get what they want, basically. So Spirit's advice to you is that the news is coming. There is communication coming towards you, and it has taken a long way, and it could take that little bit longer as well, if you're wondering. So anything else we need to know before I close the reading, Spirit? Anything else my pile freeze need to know? There you go. Thanks, Spirit. Victory. They've ended their connection with somebody. They're walking away and leaving it behind. You know, they invested a long time with this person. They're leaving it behind. That's what Spirit wants you to know. You know, victory and success and news here. I'm going to get some charms here for you guys. So the letters could be in their name, in their initials. It could be in your name, your initials. It could be a place that you both remember that, you know, meant something to both of you. So let's the letter Z, the letter P, the letter D, O, B, U, I, N, A, no, not A, L, C, got a lot of letters in here, H, O, and the last one is Q. So we've got the dragonfly. The dragonfly was in every bowl in each pile. So dragonfly is saying, like, from what I pick up with this charm here, is that things are about to take flight here. You know, things are going to start moving for both of you here. We have a tree here, so it could be a family tree, or there's room to grow, like to grow, to build a life together, basically, to lay down roots and build something together, you know, something that's strong. It's a strong foundation, you know, the roots, they just keep growing and growing, don't they? But it also could be a family tree here, that they've got family with someone else, you know, children. We've got here, yeah, look, we've got daughter here, so they could have a daughter. You could even have a daughter, but picking up more for them. You hold the key to their heart here as well. You've always been the one that's held this key to their heart. And this is why I feel like they're in this energy of the King of Swords here, being cold, because this energy that they ended up with, this person, they ended up with, I feel like they never had their heart. I feel like it was more passion, you know, that kind of relationship, and a bit of a forced relationship put upon them. So we've got cat. We've got two cats here. So two cats here, I feel like this energy is very clever. You know, cats are very clever, aren't they? Very independent. They don't like, they'll come to you, cats, when they want affection. That's the energy of the King of Swords that I'm picking up here. Very intelligent, very clever. And then we have a bicycle here. So I feel like this is like the chariot here, that they're on their way. It's a motorbike, actually, that they're on their way to see you or to communicate to you, you know. You've got the tortoise here, which is like the king, the knight of pentacles here, which has been so long in coming. It's taken a long time for this person to reach out to you. They still love you here. You've got the love here with the heart. And the butterfly here. They always remember this connection of, as being, you know, young, innocent, beautiful. And they've never let this go. And my lights flicker in like mad. So I'll take that as confirmation from spirit. I don't know if you can see that actually on the recording. But anyway. Fucking hell, all right. So, yeah. There's always been this yearning of what could have been. What should have been. So, anyway. My lovelies, if you like this reading, please hit like. If you're new to my channel, you've just come across this video, please consider to subscribe. I can't even say that properly. You have a lovely Saturday and I'll see you soon. Bye.